SEV, and if you're looking at this contraption device around my neck, it's a heart monitor. And not only do I have to wear it for 14 days, but it's itchy. I have to sleep with it on. I have to take it off when I shower and put it back on. I can't go near moisture. I can't sweat. I can't be out in the heat. There's a lot of rules around this thing. I mean, it's kind of like a watch I wear around my neck. It says the time on it, okay? It has the battery life, but there's a lot of wires, okay? It's not just these two. They're also around my ribs and my skin's very sensitive. If you wanna know why I'm wearing this, I just posted a vlog on my other channel called Vlogs. Go check it out there. I explain everything. But don't worry, I'm sure I will be okay. It was so scary because just before I started filming, there was this giant spider in the rug in my new filming studio, and it was like a big, fat, hairy black spider. But we don't kill spiders in this house. We just catch them and release them. Maybe one of my Beanie Babies like hatched all of a sudden, I don't know. Anyways, though, speaking of Beanie Babies, I have a new series all about nostalgia. It's called Twisted Nostalgia. So every week I'm going to cover one thing that we all knew and loved as kids. So today I'm talking about Lunchables. And it's so weird to make an entire video dedicated to Lunchables. Am I losing my mind? I was just researching really popular nostalgic things and Lunchables was like the top of the list. I don't know why. I mean, I do know why. They were like the bomb. I'm pretty sure most people still eat Lunchables. But I found a lot of creepy, weird, strange facts that many of you may not have known about Lunchables. So get ready because today we're delving deep. I feel like my series just keep getting weirder and weirder. Before I get started though, I know I've brought this up a lot, but if you haven't gotten your tickets for the Running with Violet premiere, the link is down below in the description. It's in Toronto, Canada. So all of my V team members in Ontario, Canada, if you want to meet me, if you want to watch me walk the red carpet, if you want to watch the series with me, that is happening on July 11th at 7 p.m. It's coming up so quickly. Tickets are going fast. The link is down below. But I do have another announcement. For those of you who don't live in Ontario, Canada, and aren't able to meet me on July 11th, I have something planned for you as well. I am doing another virtual meet and greet. It's going to be on Wednesday, July 3rd, so literally in a few days. There's only room for 30 people. Basically, you get a ticket, you get to talk to me one-on-one, virtually of course, but we're still talking live. And that event is at 6 p.m. and then at 7 p.m. following the event, there's a photo booth event, which is where we get to talk and then take a photo together online. It's really cool. There's more information down below, but basically there's two links. One is for Running with Violet, which is if you are in Ontario, Canada, and the other one is a virtual meet and greet if you're not able to meet me. So there's options for two people. Check out everything down below in the description and let's get into this nostalgic stuff. So Lunchables. This was definitely my favorite childhood lunch, and I feel like whenever you went to school and you had a Lunchable, you were automatically like the cool kid for the day. Everybody looked at you with jealousy. Everybody watched you eat your lunch and drooled on their desk wishing they were you. And I know it sounds dramatic, but admit it, people who brought their Lunchables to school were praised. No, I just feel like everybody wanted that lunch, you know what I mean? We had this tradition where every Friday my mom would pack my sister and I a Lunchable. So we only got it on Fridays if we were good. If we were bad that week, we didn't really get Lunchables, so that was like our punishment. But we always had four different ones that we kind of alternated between, and there's like 30 different Lunchables, but we only got like four different ones. So we would always have the hot dog ones, which were honestly my favorite. It was a little bit weird that the hot dogs were cold, but I liked them anyway. We had the pizza ones, which were like a classic one, but what was weird about me is I would never put the sauce on the pizza. I would never use the sauce. I would just take the little crust, I would just put cheese on top and pepperoni, and while I was eating it, it would fall everywhere because there was no sauce, but that was just my weirdness. We would have the crackers with ham and cheese. I feel like that's also like a classic one. And lastly, we would have the nacho one. I never liked salsa, so I only had the cheese. And I feel like that one was never really too filling. That was probably my least favorite one. But comment down below right now, what was your favorite Lunchable? Because there are so many out there in this world. Now, I just want to make a disclaimer before we begin. Everything I am about to tell you about Lunchables, it's not my own ideas. I researched this. I found all of these facts online. So I don't know how accurate these facts are. Not all of these facts have been confirmed by Lunchables themselves, Oscar Mayer, whatever the brand name is. I just have to make that disclaimer so I don't get in trouble by Lunchables, okay? I don't want them to come for me and like take everything that I own. okay? So let's start from the beginning. Let's go way back in time to when Lunchables were first invented. I cannot believe I'm making a video about Lunchables. I feel like other YouTubers might watch this and be like, wow, did Jessie actually lose her mind? Like, does she not have content anymore? No, this is the best content. I love nostalgic things. So this is how they started. Lunchables came out in 1985 because moms were complaining that they didn't have enough time to make their children lunches to bring to school. So there was this huge like complaint from moms all around the world, and Oscar Mayer, which is the Lunchables brand, heard their complaints and was like, hey, we know what to make. So that's when they came out with Lunchables, which is pre-made lunches. I say lunches because they're kind of processed and just kind of thrown together in a factory, but you know. Now, I want to tell you guys some rejected Lunchables names, because when they first came out with this brand, they didn't know what to call it. So before they called it Lunchables, here were the runner-ups. Entrees, Cracker Witches, okay, Mini Meals, Square Meals, Walk Meals, Go Packs, Fun Meals, and the weirdest one of them all, Smoothie Kabobbles. Smoothie Kabobbles. So I think in the end they came out with a pretty good name. So let's get into some crazy facts. So there was a huge uproar from people all around the world when Lunchables decided to remove their red sticks. Do you guys remember those little red Lunchable sticks that you use to like spread your pizza sauce and stuff? Well, I don't know if it was like a choking hazard or something, a hazard for children, but they got rid of that stick, and people all around the world were absolutely angry. I don't know why I did this. It says that there are still people mourning the loss of this red stick. Rest in peace, red stick. Apparently there are like Facebook groups out there of people mourning this red stick. I think that's a bit extreme, but like that stick was definitely useful. Okay, let's talk about a Lunchable pack they came out with that was terrible and actually very harmful to your health. This is where like the creepy, scary part of the video comes in. They came out with a line of Lunchables called Maxed Out. I don't know if you guys remember this line of Lunchables. I personally don't, but I think it was out for a couple years or something. And this was a Lunchable pack aimed more towards adults. So maybe older teens and people just in their adult lives. Now, here's what completely freaks me out to read. It says the Maxed Out pack ended up on the Cancer Project's list of the 5 worst packaged lunchbox meals in the world. They ended up on a cancer list. I mean, that's pretty disturbing if you asked me. I just spit all over my camera lens. That's disturbing as well. Apparently, if you sat down for lunch and ate this entire Maxed Out pack of Lunchables, it's like 30 times worse than eating a Big Mac. So that's like you going out and getting a ton of Big Macs and eating it in one sitting. It had 22 grams of fat. It was just packed with way too much. You didn't need that much stuff in one sitting. So people were outraged when they found out about how terrible this was for you, and I'm pretty sure they got rid of this. I'm not certain, but I kind of hope they did. Then they came out with a line of Lunchables called Uploaded. And I think this one's still out there in the world, I'm not really sure. This was a Lunchables pack aimed towards teens. So not kids, not adults, teens. And they called this pack Uploaded to seem more relatable to millennials. Because think about it, we're always on our phones, we're always watching YouTube, we're always uploading stuff or watching stuff that was uploaded. So they thought, oh my gosh, let's name it Uploaded, we'll be so relatable. But I found the ingredient list on the internet and it's like long. It's like the entire size of like a Target receipt. There are hundreds of ingredients in a simple looking Lunchable pack. How could there be that many things? One word. Preservatives. But apparently this lunch pack did really well. So I can make fun of how relatable they think they are all I want. People are buying them. The next thing they came out with was a Lunchable pack called Fun Fuel. Now this one, it didn't last very long, I don't think. This was supposed to be the healthy alternative to your normal Lunchables. Because people were complaining so much about them being so unhealthy. So they were like, hey, we'll make one that's actually kind of healthy. So you know that candy that you always got in your Lunchable? Well, they took that out. They tossed it. it, and they replaced it with yogurt. And they also went for a healthier juice option, so instead of like Kool-Aid and Capri Sun, they put like a healthy juice box in there. But when they came out with this, nobody was buying them, nobody was eating them. It actually brought their sales way, way down, so they got rid of it, because people want to be unhealthy. Now, there is a new line of Lunchables that is not out just yet, but they're coming out. And people are kind of freaking out in a good way about this, and they are called Brunchables. It comes with bacon and cheddar cheese, breakfast sausage, and cheddar cheese or ham. There's different flatbreads you can eat like your eggs and bacon in. I mean, it's a brunch in a box. There's a miniature blueberry muffin for dessert. I mean, looking at it, yeah, it does look pretty cute, but definitely let me know your opinions about this down below. Now, this next one is kind of a conspiracy theory about Lunchables that I don't know if I really believe, but people on the internet seem to. In 2013, this report was released into the public, and it said that teachers had begun to see a connection between Lunchables and negative behavioral issues in the classroom. So teachers were starting to say, hey, the kids that disturb my class the most are the ones who always eat Lunchables, like every single day. An anonymous teacher said, this is her quote, more of my Lunchable kids create behavioral problems than any of my other kids. They take shortcuts, have poor attitudes, and seem to struggle socially. I also believe that the lack of nutrition makes it difficult for the kids to function. And this report was made and a whole bunch of teachers jumped on it and agreed. I don't know how much I believe this. I mean, I definitely agree that lack of nutrition can cause behavioral problems, and there's really not much nutrition in the Lunchables. So if they have it every single day, I mean, I don't know. But that was like the whole conspiracy with the Lunchable thing, so. The next big craze all over the internet is that people are deep frying their Lunchables. Oh, there are a few videos out there on YouTube and the internet where people are doing this. Apparently it tastes good. I don't know if I would agree with that, but people are deep frying their Lunchables. The next thing is kind of funny, and that is that Kendrick Lamar came out and said that he can't look at Lunchables anymore. He admitted that the only thing he ever used to eat was Lunchables, like every single day, especially when he was touring, he was just eating Lunchables. He told a reporter, this is a quote, I ate so much of this in Europe. I got burned up. I didn't want to see another Lunchable for a long time. So they eventually made him sick because he was eating them so much. And like I said, there's not much nutrition though. This next fact is really disturbing, and that is that Kraft can only legally advertise 5 of their Lunchables. Basically, to advertise a food product, you have to meet a minimum amount of health requirements, because obviously you can't advertise something that's terrible for you or that will make you sick. So to advertise something on TV, online, that product has to meet certain health requirements. Well, what's disturbing is that Kraft has 42 Lunchables and only 5 meet those requirements. Take that in. And the last thing that I find so bizarre, and it kind of says a lot, and that is that the man who invented Lunchables won't even let his own kids eat them. So, I mean, it's just the meats in the Lunchables are pumped with a ton of water, a ton of preservatives. There's more salt in one Lunchables box than your daily recommended salt intake, so that's not very good for you. The ingredient list is like a paragraph long. And apparently this guy's daughter was interviewed, and this is a quote she said when people asked if she ate Lunchables. She said, I eat healthy. Wow. Anyways though, those are all of the weird Lunchable facts I'm gonna talk about today. If you guys enjoyed this nostalgia series, definitely give this video a thumbs up and comment down below what you want me to cover next, because there's so many things from our childhoods that I could just bring up. And I feel bad because I'm kind of like ruining our childhoods, but like it's kind of good to like find out things, right? And I hope I'm not deterring you from Lunchables. As I said, these are just facts I found online. Take them for what you will. If you want to research into it more and find out how legit these facts are, definitely do that. And it's not bad to have something unhealthy every once in a while, right? Our bodies bounce back. But health is definitely something you should concentrate on. Anyways though guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you have an awesome rest of your day, and I will see you in my next one. Bye!